Hi friends, welcome to another video of reflected XSS scripting. And in this video we'll be going to do the same thing for medium level. And if you see in the previous video, in the previous level low, there were no sanitization in this field. So if we write in like script, then alert, let's say one. So if we run this query in the low level, we get the alert pop-up box saying one. But here if we try to do so, we get no pop-up, and instead the alert one is only printed on the screen. So if we see the source page, if you see the source code, we get to know that the script tag is actually stripped by the web server, so somehow preventing the XSS attack. But there exist some other ways of doing so, but so there exist a lot of other ways of doing the same, and we are gonna look on them now. So if we use something like image source equal to some wrong source, so that it may produce error, and then we will use these on error equal to, and here we will be putting our JavaScript payload so as to execute. And if we put in alert here, and let's just try to, we also need to close the image tag, and if we run hit, we get this alert pop-up box. So the user is the server is somehow protecting the vulnerability, but still at medium level the server is not properly dealing with the sanitization, and that's the reason we are still able to perform the reflected XSS scripting vulnerability. So if we want to print in the cookie of the user, we might do it like this: on error equal to something document dot key. So we'll be making alert box doing the same. Okay, so we have got the cookie once more, but it's not the only way of doing it. There exist a lot of other ways of doing it. Let's just try something else and hope we get it. So we saw previously that it's sanitizing the script tag and removing it so that we won't be able to insert the script tag in the page source. But what if we do something called this, or if we put in something like this? What I believe the server will be doing is it will be stripping this script tag, and it will left with this. That means although it's stripping the script tag, we will also be able to produce the same result from this. So why don't we try this? So that's fine. Why don't we try this? Actually, okay, so that's not proper. Now it's proper. Let's just try this and see if we get the script tag in the page source or not, and let's view the page source. Check in for this hello string and fantastic, we are able to insert the script tag. That means we can also use this technique to pop up the alert box. So let's just try and hope we'll be able to do so. Okay, we are again able to make up a pop-up, and there exist a lot of other techniques as well, but I'm not gonna cover all, so just go Google it, and there is a book called Hacker's Handbook, and that's quite amazing to learn cross-site scripting, and you may come up with the new and creative ideas when you try to do it by your own and figure out how to solve the barriers which are there put it by the developers for you to prevent you to do such malicious things. But for now, thanks for watching, and I hope you like this video, and if you have any suggestion or want me to do something for you, please comment so that I can come to know what exactly your feedback is, and please subscribe to my channel Admiral Gauss. Thank you very much for watching.